Ashley Johnson. She is the department chair of communications and student success at Ivy Tech Community College, Southwestburg, founder of Street Littles Foundation, CEO of Ace Tax Prep LLC, real estate broker in Georgia and Kentucky.
Woo!
Author and a speaker. If we could give it up for Miss Ashley Jo.
I am Ashley Johnson. And y'all, I'm just a girl from the West End of Louisville.
Anybody else from the West End in here?
Okay, my people.
Let me have you do this. If you're from the West End, raise your hand. If you grew up in any housing project in the city of Louisville, raise your hand. If you grew up on Section 8 and food stamps, raise your hand unapologetically.
Yes,
that's me, y'all. I am you and you are me, so my story will not be unfamiliar to you.
Woo.
Y'all, they said it's only supposed to be 5 of us in this room who have done this thing. So all of the people who just raised your hand, if you have graduated from a 4-year institution with a degree, or if you have been married, raise your hand back up for me.
That's more than 5.
Yeah, both of them. That's a whole lot more than 5 people, but that's what they say about us. That's what statistics say about us. We have started and won races that we were never even supposed to find ourselves at the starting line for. We finished and won those races. Did it hurt along the way? It did. Did it hurt along the way, y'all? You don't get to the finish line without a little hurt, right? That's because preparation hurts sometimes. And one thing I know about God, he's not sending you nowhere that he don't prepare you for first. I can think back on my childhood, and y'all, like a whole lot of y'all probably, I was raised by a strong, hardworking, single Black mother.
Mm-hmm.
Yes. But an absent father. But thankfully, throughout my life, I was fortunate enough to have father figures, multiple, who encouraged me and loved me and supported me. Crazy thing is, I lost 2 of them to gun violence before I even made it to high school. And I can still remember my godmother getting down on her knees, holding my hand, looking me in my eyes as tears welled in the corner of hers, and telling me, baby, Boo is gone. And before I could open my mouth to say, gone, what? She said, no, he's gone. And he's never coming back. If that hurt. But that 7-year-old version of myself was being prepared for something. And I can think back to high school, sitting in a courtroom, crying, screaming, running to hug my mother after she was sentenced to 2 years in jail, only to be restrained by a bailiff. Imagine not letting a 16-year-old hug their mother before taking her away in cuffs. That hurt. But what hurt maybe even more was calling my daddy crying. Because in my mind, he has to save me now, right? My mama's gone. And he told me, no, you cannot live with me. And I had to figure that out. But y'all, that gave me the strength to stand on my own 2 feet, to take care of myself and my siblings. And even more than that, it showed me that no one is ever coming to save me. I have to save myself. So y'all, my childhood wasn't all bad, but these are moments of preparation that God put me in as a child. And so when I think to college, college was a period of preparation by choice for me. And this is what I love about God, is that he's no dictator. He gives us choice and free will.
Yes.
How easy would it be for God to say, peace be still, and everybody act like they got some sense down there on earth, and everything's good? No, he does not do that. He gives us choice. And one of the first and most pivotal choices that I made in college was abortion. That was my choice. to me. Not even God took that from me. I found myself in an unplanned pregnancy right as I was on the cusp of being able to make it out of where I come from. That place that y'all know just like I do. How many firstborn daughters are in the room?
Woo.
How many of you can identify with the weight of being successful to save your entire family? It is me. I am the way, I am the life for my family, for my household. I can't do that at 18 years old with a baby. And so I chose abortion, and it was the best choice for me. Every choice after that was dictated by that first choice. I chose academics because I knew I'm not gonna have an abortion and then go and flunk out of school. I chose exposure, making friends who didn't come from where I come from. My friends are from other countries. They don't even live in America right now. That exposed me to a different way of life and ultimately changed the way that I parent my children. And y'all, my last choice was a man, my husband, my personal world-class trainer. My felon from South Wick Cotter Homes, who I could take in any ballroom and he would woo every person in it. And he taught me to be unapologetically me. The periods of preparation by pain, the periods of preparation by choice. I felt like, God, I made all the right choices, so you're rewarding me. College, I ran that race, I won it. The career, I won that race. The husband, the kids, I was winning, until I wasn't. February 19, 2020, DeKalb County Police knocked on my door and told me that my husband had been shot and killed. I said, why me, God? Haven't I been through enough? And y'all, what God told me, I can't even say what God told me first. I gotta tell you what the devil tried to tell me. The devil tried to tell me that I lost. He tried to tell me that the race was over. And it wasn't until I hit rock bottom that I heard God tell me, baby, it was never about the race. The race was just preparation. And so you feel like you lost something. There's a marathon over here that I need you to run. And those races were preparation for the marathon. And that marathon is pulling yourself, your children, and every other woman who has ever or will ever lose a spouse, a husband, a boyfriend, a fiance, a baby daddy to gun violence. Y'all, I'm not supposed to be standing here today. Unapologetically me. A young black woman from the West End of Louisville, a survivor of multiple forms of abuse, born to a single mother, an absent father. I am not supposed to stand here with 2 degrees, with 2 real estate licenses. I'm not supposed to be here, but I am. And that's because God created every race, the turns, the fall downs, the get ups. He created those for me to win. Every race that you run in your life, he created it for you to win. He didn't create it for you just to go through it. He intended for you to win. And the only way you lose is if you stop running. You just have to keep going. And that's what I've done in this journey of widowhood. I didn't expect to be in this race. And if I'm being honest, it made that first choice in college null and void. And I struggled with that. I gave up a life only to become a single parent anyway. But God told me, no, that was preparation. Every choice that you made, every choice that you didn't make, every situation I gave to you was preparation for this marathon. It's gonna be hard. It's longer than a race. You're gonna need more stamina. You may feel like you're losing, but you're starting the beginning of what I called you here to do. And so as I close, I would like every woman in the building to pull out your phone. Go ahead, y'all, pull your phones out. Open your camera. Turn your camera to selfie mode. I want you to look at yourself in that phone. And I want you to repeat after me. The only way I lose, is if I stop running. So run, girl, run.
Run, girl, run.
When you go home and hug your daughters, today, I want you to tell them, run, girl, run. When you look at your mother, who's still carrying that generational trauma that you already healed from,
woo!
I want you to tell her what?
Run, girl, run.
When you come across a street widow, whether it's your sister, your cousin, your best friend, your mother, or if it's you, when any woman who you know loses a significant other to gun violence, to substance abuse, to suicide, to police brutality, I want you to tell her what?
Run, girl, run.
And on this Tuesday, on this magnificent Tuesday coming up, when we run to the polls to elect the first black female president of the United States, when she wins the race that God already designed for her to win, y'all, but she starts that marathon of having to work across the aisle with people who really feel some type of way about her, but they like her a little more than they do Trump. When she starts that marathon of changing this country for the better, I want y'all to tell her.
Run, girl, run.
Let's go elect the first black woman president of this country on Tuesday.